Thank you very much, Hoshiyama. Today I would like to talk about all-photonic quantum repeaters. This work was done with collaborator Dr. Kiyoshi Tamaki and Professor Hoikon Lo. Let's start. As well known, one of the big issues in quantum information science is how to realize quantum information processing. Actually, the quantum information processing is composed of two big applications. One is quantum computation, the other is quantum communication. If we see the realization of quantum computing, we can easily find the existence of many candidates at this point. Somebody says that the ion trap seems to be a good candidate to realize quantum computation. Somebody says that a superconducting qubit seems to be a good candidate. At this point, I cannot say which system is better than the others. However, I can say one thing. Actually, the computation is not fastidious about the types of physical system, as long as the physical system has a good controllability as a quantum system. This comes from the fact that quantum computation is ultimately just a local information processing. Therefore, if we have a good quantum system, then such a system can be regarded as a good candidate to realize quantum computation. On the other hand, quantum communication is completely different. Actually, in order to perform the communication, photons should be special. In addition, even in the future, even in the far future, photons should play the central role in the implementation of the quantum communication. In fact, we have already achieved the quantum communication up to 300 kilometers by using the direct transmission of single photon over optical fibers. And this is good news. However, this type of method has a limitation on the achievable distance. This is close to the 300 kilometer. Actually, this limitation comes from the photon loss, which increases exponentially with channel distance. In order to extend such achievable distance of quantum communication, we need to use quantum repeater. Somebody says that we need to use not only photons, but also matter quantum memory here. However, this situation looks very strange in the sense that all the other applications in the quantum information science can be done by using only a single system. However, that only quantum repeater theory enforces us to use different physical systems at the same time. Namely, in the quantum repeater theory, enforces us to use physical system in a hybrid manner. Namely, in this case, that we need to use photons and matter quantum memory. If we see the realization of the matter quantum memory, we can easily find out the two types of system. One is an atomic ensemble system. The other one says that we need to use matter qubits such as NV center, a diamond, a quantum dot, and so on. However, unfortunately, if we would like to use atomic ensemble quantum memory, in such a case that infinite coherence time is required for the atomic ensemble according to the recent theory. And namely, more precisely, in order to perform the polynomial scaling quantum repeater, in such a case, infinite coherence time is needed here. Therefore, in addition that we cannot find a good way to make the atomic ensemble for tolerant quantum memory because this is not a real qubit system, just a pseudo-qubit system. And so some theorists suggest we need to use matter qubit system. And however, all the conventional theory requires us to use matter qubit based quantum computer at each repeater node. Moreover, such a matter qubit based quantum computer should have an efficient coupling with photons. Therefore, the matter qubit requires satisfied not only de Vincenzo's five criteria for universal computation, but also his really difficult extra criteria about the efficient coupling with photons. Therefore, I cannot say whether the quantum repeater is really much easier than the matter qubit based quantum computer at this point. Therefore, if we follow the dogma of the necessity of matter quantum memory in the quantum repeaters may be much more difficult than quantum computer. This is undeniable from a theoretical perspective without the future experimental breakthrough. Actually, I await such arrival of experimental breakthrough, however. Today, I would like to mention about a new quantum repeater scheme. This is much simpler than a quantum computer. And seems to be the ultimate challenge for the all-optical approach in the conventional communication. We call it all-photonic quantum repeaters. Therefore, my main message of this talk is just I would like to exclude the necessity of matter quantum memory in the quantum repeaters. This is the main conclusion. More precisely, our protocol just uses optical devices, such as the linear optical elements, single photon sources, photon detectors, and fast active feed forward techniques. That's it. We do not need to use matter quantum memory at all. And our protocol looks like this, namely, each repeater node first prepared entangled photons sends just adjacent repeater node. That's it. And thanks to excluding the necessity of the attack quantum memory in the quantum repeater, our protocol has own distinguished advantage. The first advantage is the repetition rate of our protocol could be increased as high as 1 watt because we just used optical devices. In addition that we do not need to use coherent frequency converter for photons to strengthen coupling with matter quantum memory and with optical fiber because our protocol can work by using only teleco wavelength single photons. In addition, all the optical components described here are much simpler than matter quantum memory in the sense that if we have good matter quantum memory, such matter quantum memory can be used to realize the demanding optical devices described here. However, the converse is not true. And so all the optical components much simpler than matter quantum memory. In addition that we just use the optical devices. And so in principle, it could work at room temperature. In addition that actually our protocol is the only scheme that is proven to be much simpler than a quantum computer by comparing with the optical computer based on the Neil Laframe-Milver. Okay, how to realize such an all-photonic quantum repeater? The main idea is very simple. Just take the time reversal of the quantum repeater based on the DLCG protocol. Okay, and so that's why I would like to start my talk by briefly reviewing the DLCG type quantum repeater. The DLCG type quantum repeater is composed of two steps. First step is entanglement generation. The second step is entanglement swapping. The aim of the entanglement generation looks like this. Namely, here the aim is just to establish entanglement between two adjacent repeater nodes. In order to perform that, actually we first prepare the locally entanglement between photons and matter quantum memory. Photon is sent to the intermediate node. Intermediate node just performs the Bell measurement. If the Bell measurement succeeds, the entanglement should be established between adjacent node. If the Bell measurement fails, in this case that we should not obtain the entanglement at all. This is a mechanism of the entanglement generation process. In order to perform the quantum repeater, in addition to the entanglement generation process, we need to use entanglement swapping. Let us go back to the original DLCG proposal. In this proposal, the author assumes the use of the ideal matter quantum memory. Namely, here that we need to assume the use of the quantum memory with infinite coherence time. And the protocol proceeds as follows. Namely, for simplicity, let us consider the following experiment. Namely, two end parties are separated, and the two end parties share just a single repeater for simplicity. The DLCG protocol starts like this, namely, intermediate node start entanglement generation process in parallel fashion, and suppose that in the first trial we are unlucky, both of the entanglement generation process fails. After that, we are lucky. In the second trial, we left-hand side entanglement generation succeeds, on the other hand, right-hand side entanglement generation fails. However, we have quantum memory here. Once entanglement is established, the entanglement should be preserved until the right-hand side entanglement generation process succeeds. After the entanglement is established in the both sides, in such a case, we just perform the Bell measurement. This is the protocol of the DLCG quantum repeater. However, in practice, matter quantum memory also has exponential decay with time, right? And so this preservation time should correspond to the infidelity for the entanglement preserved in the matter quantum memory. Therefore, in order to perform the quantum repeater, somebody suggests that we need to use a multiplexed version to relax the requisite for memory time. For matter quantum memory. In this case, this protocol is very simple. We just replace the horizontal axis time with space. Namely, in this protocol, we just use a lot of matter quantum memory locally, and we just start entanglement generation in parallel fashion simultaneously. In this case, after the first trial of the entanglement generation, one of the entanglement generation succeeds in the left-hand side or right-hand side case. After that, we just perform the Bell measurement. That's it. Therefore, this protocol contributes to relax the requisite for memory time. And however, if we use multiplexing, we still need matter quantum memory. Why? The reason is very simple. Okay, let us consider a little bit complicated situation where we just assume the use of three repeater nodes between two end parties. And some entanglement generation protocol succeeds, some entanglement generation fails. After that, we need to perform the Bell measurement here, looks like this. Namely, more precisely, second and third repeater node should perform the Bell measurement. However, in order to perform such a Bell measurement, we need to wait the arrival heralding signal, which informs us whether the entanglement generation succeeds or fails. And And in addition, after that, we should proceed to this type of configuration, namely in the intermediate repeater node, also perform the Bell measurement for the qubit pair that have been successfully entangled with left-hand side and right-hand side repeater nodes. However, this entanglement swapping succeeds only probabilistically in the case of the DLCZ quantum repeater because we just use the linear optical elements photon detector to perform the Bell measurement. Therefore, we need to still wait the arrival of heralding signal again. And so that's why the minimum time to establish that entanglement between two end party, this time is already proportional to the overall distance for L0 here. Therefore, even if we use matter quantum memories or multiplexing, heralding signals are needed to be exchanged over long distances. Okay. And this is the reason why the quantum repeat memory is required. However, please note that the two facts in this consideration. Namely, we assume the entanglement swapping succeeds only probabilistically. In this case, the waiting time for exchanging heralding signal is proportional to overall distance. In addition, let us consider that defacing or depolarization for quantum memory increases exponentially with time. By combining these facts, we can conclude that the exponential scaling of the DLCZ type quantum repeater. Actually, in order to perform the polynomial scaling quantum repeater, we need to perform the deterministic Bell measurement. Or we need to go back to the Brieger et al. Scheme where we just assume the use of the matter qubit based quantum computer at each repeater node. And so, in order to perform the quantum repeater by using only photons, I would like to introduce a time reversed version of the DLCZ quantum repeater. Okay, in order to introduce such a scheme, let us go back to the multiplex version of the DLCZ quantum repeater. In this scheme, we need to perform the intermediate node should perform the Bell measurement depending on the success or failure of the entanglement generation process. Let us call such a qubit C and D here. And what is the role of the Bell measurement here, right? The Bell measurement looks like this, namely entangling gate followed by X-based measurement for simplicity. In this case, let us imagine the following situation, namely after the application of the entangling gate for the qubits C and D, the situation looks like this, namely qubits C and D entangled from first, and after that, we just perform the X-based measurement. In such a case, entanglement is extended to the two-end party, right? And so this simple observation is very important because let us consider the following situation. If we have entangled qubits C and D from first, then only single qubit measurements are needed, right? And the single qubit measurement should work deterministically even for the almost all the system, including the photonic system. Therefore, this is important for us. Our main goal is to produce the left-hand side situation from the first. And in such a case, we just perform the single qubit measurement alone. This should work deterministic way. However, we cannot predict initially which pair becomes a successfully entangled pair, qubit C and D. And so we would like to propose this type of situation. Namely, from the first, initially we first prepared complete graph state locally. After that, we start entanglement generation. Depending on success or failure of the entanglement generation process, we perform the X-based measurement qubits C and D. For the others, we just apply the G-based measurement. This is the same action. Therefore, we call it time reversed quantum repeater in the sense that in our protocol, we first perform the entanglement swapping in some sense. After that, we start entanglement generation. Okay, and I have already introduced a time reversed quantum repeater. And here, please remember that how to supply the adjacent, namely two green qubit with entanglement. And please remember that this configuration can be used to supply the qubits, supply the adjacent repeater nodes with entanglement. And therefore, the entire picture looks like this. Namely, each repeater node prepares this type of complete right graph state. After that, blue photon is sent to the intermediate node, just to perform the Bell measurement. And depending on the success or failure of the Bell measurement here, we just need to perform X basis or G basis measurement on the green qubit, right? And however, important thing here is what is really important here is just perform the single qubit measurement for green qubit. Therefore, we are not necessary to realize green qubit by using matter quantum memory at all. Namely, green qubit can be regarded as a single photons that are sent with blue qubit to know the measurement outcome of the Bell measurement outcome for the green qubit. Therefore, at this point, we can notice that every qubit described here can be done by using only photons. And however, that, please note that if we try to send the green qubit as well as the blue qubit, in such a case, green qubit receives the photon loss. In order to perform the single qubit measurement deterministically under the loss, we need to use a loss code. And we just use the Barnabas-Tarr code, which is produced by the, in the context of the quantum computation for the, anyway, we just use the Barnabas-Tarr code. Okay, I would like to summarize our protocol. In our protocol, we first prepare this type of complete light graph state locally. And actually, this type of preparation can be done by just using 20 times use of the adaptive feed forward measurement locally, which is based on the just optical devices. And anyway, after the preparation time, after preparation, we just send to the, such an entangled photon to the adjacent repeater node. And after the transmission, we just perform the Bell measurement on blue qubit. Depending on the outcome, we need to perform the X or G based measurement on green qubit. And with a high success probability in this case, two end parties can be connected by entanglement. And so the property of our protocol is looks like this. Namely, we just take the time reversal of the polynomial scaling quantum repeater. Therefore, total photon number required here is just a polynomial with overall distance. In addition, that our protocol just uses optical devices. Therefore, we can repeat our protocol by using with the repetition rate of the slowest optical devices here. This is actually independent of the communication distance. In addition, that we can show the robustness against the even general error in the transmission channel, thanks to the special robustness of the Barnabas-Tarr code. Okay, thanks to the finding out the all-photonic quantum repeater, the situation becomes changed. Namely, even quantum repeater are possible by using optical devices or only photons. And if we see the quantum computation, of course, a photon is also a good candidate to realize it. Therefore, we can now understand every kind of quantum information processing by photons alone. Therefore, photons seem to be a unified language to compare the complexity of any kind of quantum information processing. My final message of this talk is just think with photons. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. We have probably question time for question or
I don't understand how you can generate all those pairs of entanglement that you need to substitute.
Sorry, entanglement pair? Okay.
You need a complete graph
of
entanglement.
Yes. Actually,
right?
this can be done by using the probabilistic entangling gate for photonic qubit. Actually, that this is done by just using the simple parity check measurement in the linear optical elements. And so that's why that this can be done by using only linear optical elements.
Okay, so your probability of outcome will fall, and you will have to repeat the experiment many times more, right?
Yeah, actually, we prepared a lot of photons in parallel fashion. We just applied the probabilistic gate in a knockout tournament fashion.
So, just one more question, Nicola.
Yeah, thank you for this nice talk. So you said that we need infinitely long coherence time for matter repeater, quantum memories, and that is correct in the limit of infinitely long distances.
Exactly.
But of course, for finer distances,
yes,
that is not correct.
Yes.
And for instance, for 1,000 kilometers, 100 milliseconds would suffice. And in the limit of infinitely long distances, also you need your highly entangled state would also require infinitely many qubits and infinitely many photons. So just make it fair between the two.
Actually,
let me ask the question. For 1,000 kilometers, how many photons do you need to entangle at each node?
Actually, in the case of the case that this type of, I think you can easily find from my paper. And actually, the many photons still needed. But I'd like to mention about such
a...
10 to the 98,
yes?
Sorry? No. This is just a direct transmission case. We just need to just 10 to 7 or 10 to 6.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much.